Bonjour. Today, I'm not gonna talk about going to the beach in Brittany, but I'd love to go. I'm gonna talk about something even more exciting. The French checks. Did you know French people still use their checkbooks regularly? It can also be useful if you live in France to have a checkbook. Let's see why, how to use it, and the pros and cons of using this type of payment. I'm Giga, French from Lyon. I've lived in many different countries, but I never needed to use a checkbook there. You will soon know why this is different in France. I also blog at Expat in France if you like written content, and recently I started this YouTube channel to help English-speaking expats to decode the French systems and culture. Have you ever tried to pay a service by card and have been told that they don't accept it, but only payment in cash or check? Many health professionals, independent doctors, or small businesses don't accept card payments. The payment terminal is quite expensive and French people still use their checks. You may want to decide to get a checkbook from your French bank. Let's see why. And if you're unsure how to use a French check, I will also tell you the things to be careful about, how to fill it out, but also what to do when you receive a check. Why is it a good idea to get a checkbook from your French bank? Well, first, it's free. Until quite recently, before the appearance of the online banks in France, the check was the only free way of payment. You may have noticed that having a debit or credit card in France is far from being free, and that French banks charge many fees. For example, if you withdraw more than 4 or 5 times a month outside of your bank ATM network. Every bank has its own pricing policy, but there is one constant rule. The checkbook and its use is totally free of charge for the person making the check or cashing it. Then two, it's easy to keep track of the payments. When paying by check, you will also fill out the check stub on the side, which is considered as a proof of payment together with the money movement on your bank account, matching the check number. So it's common to see French people keeping their check stub for several years. My mom, for example, has a full box of them. This can be useful when an invoice is not given, for example. But this also means that you should make sure to fill out the check stub side when writing a check. Then number three, this is handy when making large payments. The most common payment to make by check, besides the doctor's appointment, is a security deposit. When moving into a long-term rental, you will be required to pay a 1 or 2 month rent security deposit. Most people prefer to pay by check and see with the owner when to cash it. Also, compared to many other countries, the credit card is not as frequent as the debit card. So paying by check in several installments is another way to spread out payments and also avoid bank fees. If you receive payments by check, keep in mind that the check will be valid for 1 year and 8 days exactly. Past that date, the beneficiary won't be able to cash the check. But there are a few things you need to watch out for. First, a shopkeeper has the right to refuse check payment or can set a minimum or maximum amount to pay by check. This must be clearly indicated at the counter. Then the beneficiary can also request 1 or 2 proof of payment with photo to avoid blank checks. Also, make sure that you have the amount in your bank account as the check will be rejected if you don't have the funds. As anything else, there is a risk to lose or to have your check stolen. In that case, you can cancel the check via the emitting bank. There are cases of lost checks by the postal mail, so if you are paying someone remotely in France, I would recommend paying by bank transfer. A small thing to keep in mind. The French older generation still has the habit to pay by check or request payments by check and will not always think to pay or receive payment by card. Finally, there is a risk of counterfeiting, so it's important to fill out your check correctly and fully, as we will see now. First, you must fill out the amount in letters, in French, at the top left-hand corner, and in number, in the square, at the top right-hand corner. The two values must match. If there is a discrepancy, the bank will take the amount written in letters into account. This is a good opportunity to learn how to write the numbers in French, right? Watch out for the way you write the values in number. In France, the comma is used before the cent and the dot can be used between the thousands and the hundreds. It's basically the other way around than Anglo-Saxon countries. Then, under the number value section, you should write the city where you are when giving the check and below the day's date under the format day, month, year. Again, different from the American format, for example. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe everywhere in Europe and more, the day, month, year format is used. Make sure you fill in the recipient's number properly. Always confirm with the recipient how you should address the check. And finally, sign the check. You might be surprised, but this is often forgotten. For your own accounting, fill in the check stub side by entering the value, the date, and the recipients. So now that you know how to fill out a French check, let's see what you should do to cash one. Let's say that a French grandma gave you a check for your birthday or that your client gave you a payment by check. Do you know what you need to do to cash it? If you have an account with an online bank like Boursorama or ING, you should see with them directly, as some online bank will request you to send the check by post and others will accept a digitalized check. We will see here the process to cash your check if you have an account with a French bank that has physical agencies. First, when you receive a check, make sure the information on it is correct as explained before. Then you need to sign the check on the back side and write your own bank account number. Some banks also provide a check deposit book, so you should fill in one check deposit sheet and join it with your signed check. If you have an account with La Poste, you would have been provided with a prepaid envelope specifically addressed to the check department at La Poste. Otherwise, you can bring your check with the deposit slip at your local bank. When the bank is closed, you can put your check in an envelope and put it in the bank mailbox. That's what I do and it works perfectly. Remember to write your bank account number and sign at the back of the check before depositing it at your bank. This is important. Also, you will be able to cash a check from another EU member state. However, you will have expensive fees to cash it. So I recommend you to refuse any foreign check and ask the person to make a SEPA transfer. The transfer fees may vary from one bank to another, both to make the transfer or to receive it. To avoid this complication, I am personally a big fan of TransferWise services. This is an international payment service that offers great exchange rate and transfer fee about 10 times cheaper than most banks. I've used it for transfer from France to the UK, from the UK to France, and from France to Brazil, and I've always been happy. It is fast, easy, cheap and efficient. If you want to test it, you can get a free transfer of up to 500 euros or equivalent with the link in the description below. I hope you found this information useful. If you did, you can like the video and subscribe to the channel for more expat dedicated content. Merci et à bientôt!